I'm not that concerned about Pogo pulling out, for example, because as far as the group is concerned, our exposure to Pogo is very minimal.
How minimal?
In terms of, for example, the office buildings we have, our offices are designed more for BPOs and KPOs, so there's only very few, if any, Pogo in our commercial buildings.
For the KPOs and BPOs, has demand been maintained or has that change slowed because of the trade war? Are you seeing any impact from the global risks out there?
So far, demand continues to be very strong. I mean, even here in the Mall of Asia area, we just opened a new e-com building here, and it's already fully booked with BPO KPOs as well.
And these weren't relocations because of the disruptions of the trade war. They were looking for alternative sites like the Philippines?
There are some, I hear, okay, it has to be confirmed, but I know there are some multinationals, for example, who are in China at the moment, and because of the trade war, there's some concerns about the future, so they're actually sort of diversifying to other countries. And one of the countries which they tend to look at is the Philippines.
What about for retail? There's a lot of movement in Alpha Mart. I've been seeing more branches throughout the whole country.
Again, consumer sentiment continues to be quite robust, right? And we don't expect that to weaken anytime soon. And as, again, economic development spreads more to the provinces and you introduce more sort of modern retail concepts there, the demand should be fairly strong.
You have China exposure. You've got 7 malls in China out of the 65 or more than 65 malls in the Philippines. What is your strategy as the U.S.-China trade war evolves and as the prospect of slower consumer confidence and sentiment evolves within China because of the trade war?
The malls we have in China are more in the secondary cities, for example, and they've been there for some time, so they're pretty much established. And even though there's the trade potential, continuing trade war between the US and China, the Chinese local consumption continues to be very strong. And if I'm not mistaken, the Chinese government is actually trying to sort of improve local consumption as opposed to relying more on exports, right?